Then Sabine had another idea for herself, which we, from our company, decided to put that.
Well, she did this CyberNet. We just started getting on CyberNet.
Nobody knew how to configure for a Mac. So all the dealers would come in and send, vendors would come in and say, people, well, Mac pe to chalta nahi internet. Ya Mac pe to email ho nahi sakti. So, all right. So this was when you put it in.
It was a tutorial.
A tutorial, and it can help you configure.
Yeah.
That had, the first time that it had a little more animation in it, you know, because it allowed things to come in. And so, so as new techniques were scouring the forums for finding out how to learn, none of us were IT people in the background. So it was great fun. And this led to, I think, Nisar Memon's...
When really, we decided to pitch.
He wanted to go to do something 40 years of IBM in Pakistan, nearly the 50th year of Pakistan, not quite yet. And South Africa was their regional office, and they were looking at somebody in Singapore, India, and wherever else to get a multimedia CD mail. And when we went and told them that, you know, we can do it.
Obviously, he said, what does we mean? There were four of us.
We told him that there are four of us in the company, and we can do it. And he said, we've got something to show, and we showed them these little bits. And, you know, it was IBM, and first of all, three of us who had walked into his office were wearing Mac t-shirts, which was pretty frowned upon.
First thing he did was to make us change into IBM t-shirts.
No, he didn't text as an IDP. He gave us those little IBM OS.
He made me change into an IBM.
Well, maybe he wanted to see you change.
Which had that IBM on it, you know, the I and then a B.
That's right. Anyway, so we got that. And we showed it to him, and he said, are you sure you can handle this? Of course, we've done lots of it. Which we've done nothing of.
But we must give him credit.
No, but he understood that. Despite opposition in his office, he gave us this job. And he said, all right, if Pakistan can do it, fine. But it will have to be passed by the South African agent who got them. So we sat down, and they were going to do a history of IBM and catalog of their products in the interactive series. And we thought that was boring. So we said, can we put in a little part about Pakistan? So we added culture, music, history, and some quizzes about IBM that most people at IBM couldn't answer.
And Charlie Chaplin.
And for my own self, the best part of that quiz was actually teaching IBM people about IBM, because, you know, they didn't realize that there were four Nobel Prize winners working in their offices in worldwide.
And the fact that we didn't have, they didn't have a photograph of their first CEO,
who was country manager for many years. I must tell this story. I'm sorry if I'm going to take time, but this is important. Dadi Saab was the first CEO.
Yes.
We've also had a photograph of the first IBM computer coming off from the port and going into this high-tech thing, going on a gada gadi or a ghoda gadi or something, being carried into it. But that was fine. But what was important was that Dadi Saab ki koi photograph nahi thi in his formal suit dress. And we had Kareem, we had all these.
And where we did have it, his eyes were closed.
His eyes were closed. So we finally got one, enlarged it. Now you think back, this is also
96.
Yeah. So, 96 men. So, we're now getting this little Photoshop one type of thing. And I've got somebody else's suit put onto Mr. Dadi. And I've also got somebody else's eyes and put that onto Mr. Dadi. But he looks Dadi-ish anyway. The fun thing is that we've got the suit off from another IBM picture. And the question I'm asked by this high-tech guy at IBM, ki aapne unka suit unko pehna hai, fit aa gaya. So, excuse me. This is Photoshop. It's about shrinking.
It was really funny. So anyway, we got this.
And then the South African people came. It was really, I must admit, Nisar not only supported us, the company was upset by the fact that we were working all on Macs, but then also there was only available at that time on Macs and only a player on Windows, which is the reverse now.
Yeah.
But so we had to work on Macs and transfer everything to an IBM to show it to them. And this
so
was very difficult.
He gave us an IBM PC.
Yes, but it was very difficult to take this across. So we asked him to come. And when I first phoned up his secretary and I said, well, would you please ask Mr. Nisar Memon if he wants to see it, can he come across to our office? They were horrified. I mean, how dare three twerps in IT ask the giant of the industry, the chairperson of that? He was a big shot,
yes.
IBM's chairman.
He still is,
but in different ways. But so for him to come here to our office, and he was casual, he walked.
Yes.
It was absolutely amazing. So he walked and he brought people. Then he brought the South African region person who still had doubts that Pakistan could do it. But she came and saw it and she said, this is wonderful. You guys can go ahead. So we got the contract and we produced. That was the first CD-ROM that got produced.
Yes.
And then it was a kiosk produced to go with it so that they could take that by, not donkey cart this time, but by some van into different cities and show them.
Correct.
Seeing that ICI wanted something else, and we did something for them, and then made their first large kiosk.
And then the first Jaffa G's interactive product catalog.
Product catalog came out that you could place orders online on that. It was really amazing. So it was good fun. I think where, as a company, financially, we never did well as much, was because...
That's because we were having too much fun.
Yeah, we were having too much fun, and we had one thing which was... I'm saying this to people who are IT people, that maybe you should never fall into this trap. Chances are you won't, but please never do. We decided that instead of the tried and true formula, that once you, if you've got this mug, then the way it becomes cheap is that you produce 5 million of them with one mold. If you want every mug to be a different shape, it's going to be very expensive. This was it. We'd done this. We'd countered here. We'd calculated something new here. We'd got a new idea. The next CD won't have it, or the next product won't be a CD or something else. It's got to be different. But there was never a template, and each one took us the same amount of time.
But the best part was that when we moved on to things like ABN AMRO, who then asked us to do 50 years of art in Pakistan, which we proposed to them because there were art people everywhere around the world, they were doing art. And we did 50 years of art in Pakistan, and I really hoped by this time we'd got mature onto author work, etc., that a lot more people in Pakistan, because we obviously no one company, no one, anyone can claim to do everything. And if we did 50 years of art in Pakistan, it was not our expertise, it may have been our interest. My wife was doing a lot of research, and it was her interest. But in this valley, we took two people who were then students, who are now teachers, recognized teachers of art and artists, to do the research for us, because there's got to be expertise coming in. I've seen a lot of other CD-ROM and new media material, mediocre or worse. Where it fails is that the content is nothing that those people are aware of. So,
domain experts should be involved, because they understand the content.
Absolutely, they have to understand, and they also understand their audience. I mean, you might want to put a little Cheska, which may not go very well with the 90-year-old heart patients that they're trying to target.
They know where to have access to this content.
So that the 50 years of art in Pakistan was, I think, very good. Really interesting that 10 years after the 50 years of art in Pakistan has come and gone, it was never commercially sold. ABN AMRO distributed it. My neighbor comes to me and said, I've just been to Singapore for a medical conference.
From Pfizer, Jimmy.
And he said, I brought a CD from there, and it's from Pakistan. So I said, you bought it in Singapore? I didn't think it was sold. He said, no, the conference was one of the sponsors, was ABN AMRO, with 300 delegates from the worldwide, and this is what ABN AMRO presented in the package.
Wow.
And that's our art CD.
So they obviously replicated it.
And they may have, stocks left. I mean, I don't know what they did.
Yes.
Or maybe the Pakistan batch sent it to them for some eventual... Fair. But this is great to see that so many years later, it could be presented as something that could still be of value.
But it would have been of more value, I feel. I was personally quite upset that they did not decide to then have it replicated in 2000s and made sure that it was available at universities and available to the public. They said, we don't want to make money off it, but...
Yeah, they didn't have to make money, but they weren't. They said, we have no slot for this kind.
Yes.
Well, this is corporations. You know, they can't fit into anything outside whatever is written in there.
Yes.
We had
Which is sad.
Yeah, but I mean, it did get pirated for a little while in this valley, because I made a presentation there and I told the students, here's a copy for your library, please copy it. Every student wanted it because there are 112 artists, their biographies, their works, their analyses, their videos.
Quite comprehensive.
It's quite comprehensive. Thank you.
That was an amazing session with Zaheer Alam Khidwai, who is, I don't know, you can't describe him in one sentence, but he took us through a nostalgic journey of how new media has been used in Pakistan and how sad it is that it hasn't been used more. And he has thrown a challenge to Rabia and me to try and do something about it. So Rabia, let's do something about it. Until next time, this is Jahan Arad.